वेलकम टू वीडियो क्लास. दिस इज के दामोदर रेड्डी, लेक्चर इन केमिस्ट्री, गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज फॉर वुमेन वनप्रति. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फोटोकेमिस्ट्री. सो फोटोकेमिस्ट्री डील्स विथ फोटोकेमिकल रिएक्शंस कॉज्ड बाय द अब्सॉर्प्शन ऑफ लाइट रेडिएशन फ्रॉम visible and ultraviolet region. So see here, electromagnetic spectrum has gamma rays to radio waves. In chemical photochemical reactions, ultraviolet and visible radiation is useful. So we are going to what is the thermal reaction and photochemical reactions. For thermal reactions, these are ordinary chemical reactions which are influenced by temperature, concentration, pressure, catalyst, etc., except the radiation. So in thermal reactions, not useful radiation, maybe UV radiation or visible radiation. These reactions involve evaluation of heat. The reaction is called as the exothermic reaction, or absorption of heat, endothermic reaction. So thermal reactions are ordinary chemical reactions which are influenced by temperature, concentration, pressure, catalyst, except the radiation. So thermal reactions are two types: exothermic reaction, endothermic reaction. In exothermic reaction, in these reactions involve evaluation of heat. Endothermic reaction, these reactions involve absorption of heat, called endothermic reaction. So see here, photochemical reactions. The reaction which is induced by the absorption of electromagnetic radiation. So UV visible region, mainly in electromagnetic radiation, UV visible region of radiation observed in photochemical reactions. So therefore, the reaction which is induced by the absorption of electromagnetic radiation is called as photochemical reactions. Photochemical reactions. So see here, examples for thermal and photochemical reactions. In thermal reactions, so two types of reactions are there: exothermic and endothermic reactions. So here, exothermic reactions, examples: N2 plus 3H2 giving rise to 2NH3 plus delta T, 4NH3 plus 5O2 giving rise to 4NO plus 6H2O plus delta T. These reactions, evaluation of heat is observed. Therefore, the thermal reactions is called as the exothermic reactions. For endothermic reactions, examples: N2 plus O2 giving rise to 2NO minus delta T. So absorption of heat in this reaction is observed. So C plus 2H, C plus H2O giving rise to CO plus H2 minus of delta T. So here, heat is absorbed. That's why the thermal reactions is called as endothermic reactions. See here, photochemical reactions: H2 plus Cl2 giving rise to 2HCl. So So the reaction between H2 and Cl2 in the presence of sunlight giving us 2HCl. Without sunlight, no reaction is there. So that's why you can take the high concentration of H2, high concentration of Cl2, no reaction. Only in the presence of light, these molecules undergoing reaction. That's why in this reaction, the sunlight is important. So that's why this is called as a photochemical reaction. But in the case of 6CO2 plus 12H2O, in the presence of sunlight using chlorophyll, you can get the carbohydrates, glucose, with H2O plus, like this. So this is a photosynthesis reaction. Photosynthesis reaction. So here also sunlight is used. Without sunlight, no reaction is there. So that's why this is also photochemical reaction. See here, plants having chlorophyll molecules. So using water and carbon dioxide in the weather, in the presence of sunlight, the plants are preparing carbohydrates, evaluation of oxygen. This is also photochemical reactions. This is a natural photosynthesis reaction. So here the radiation is used. Without radiation, the reaction is not occur. So see here, carbon cycle also example for photochemical reaction. So from industries, evaluation of carbon dioxide, these carbon dioxide molecules takes up plants with water and sunlight, giving us to oxygen for human beings. This is the called as the photosynthesis reaction. The formation of ozone also example for this reaction. So from sunlight, UV, ultraviolet rays dissociate the oxygen, single oxygens. These single oxygens combined with the oxygen in a environment, so preparing the ozone. So this is the photochemical reaction. Another example for photochemical reactions. What is the difference between photochemical reactions and thermochemical reactions? Thermochemical reactions, these reactions involve absorption of evaluation of heat. So photochemical reactions, these reactions involve absorption of light. So without light, no photochemical reaction. So in thermochemical reactions, even in absence of light, that's why this is also called as the dark reactions. So thermochemical reactions also called as the dark reaction. That means no using light. So absence of light, these reactions giving us products. The presence of light is the primary requisite for the reaction to take place. Without light, no chemical reaction occur. So temperature has a significant effect on the rate of the thermochemical reaction. So in this photochemical reaction, temperature has a very little effect on the rate of photochemical reaction. Instead, the intensity of light has marked effect on the rate of photochemical reaction. So that's why you can understood. So here, thermochemical reactions, temperature is a effect on thermochemical reaction, temperature effect on rate of thermochemical reaction. Only here, photochemical reaction, temperature has very little effect on rate of photochemical reaction. The free energy changes keeps free energy delta Z of a thermochemical reaction is always negative. The free energy changes delta Z, that means Gibbs free energy of photochemical reactions may not be negative. This is delta Z is positive in photochemical reactions, delta Z negative for thermochemical reactions. In thermochemical reactions, accelerated by the presence of a catalyst. Some of these are initiated by the presence of photosensitizer. However, photosensitizer act as in a different ways than a catalyst. So see here, differences between thermochemical reactions and photochemical reactions. Here involve absorption or evolution of heat. Here absorption of light. So this is also called as the thermochemical reactions, also called as the dark reactions. That means these reactions proceed via absence of light. Whereas without light, these reactions are not occur in the reaction condition. So here, rate of reaction effect on temperature. Here, only little effect on rate of photochemical reaction. Temperature has very little effect on the rate of a photochemical reaction. The free energy changes gives a free energy delta Z always negative in thermochemical reaction. Whereas the delta Z is not be negative, this is positive. So in photochemical reactions. So in thermochemical reactions accelerated by the presence of a catalyst. Whereas in this initiated by the presence of photosensitizer. In photochemistry, important laws are Grothe-Stefan law and Stark-Einstein law. Only light that is observed can produce photochemical changes. So without light, no photochemical reaction. This is Grothe's Draper law of photochemistry. A molecule absorbs a single quantum of light is becoming excited. So that is called as the Einstein-Stark law. These two laws are important in photochemistry. Grothe-Stefan law, only those radiations which are absorbed by a reacting substances or system are responsible for producing chemical change. According to this law, all light radiations are not bringing the chemical reaction. Some are increases the kinetic energy of molecule, while some are re-emitted. That is the molecule undergoing physical changes, that means fluorescence and phosphorescence. Later on discussed, fluorescence, what is the fluorescence, what is the phosphorescence according to Jablonski diagram. So the nature of light, light behaves as a wave nature and light behaves as a particle nature. This is the dual nature of a light. Light behaves as a wave nature. So according to the wave nature of light, the properties are wavelength, frequency. What is the wavelength? Distance between successive crests or troughs. What is the frequency? So it is denoted by nu, wavelength denoted by lambda. Number of crests or troughs that pass a point per second. What is the speed of light? C is equal to nu into lambda. This is the frequency. This is the wavelength. So solar energy, E is equal to H nu. It's the energy come from the sun or other radiant sources. What is the Einstein Stark law or Stark-Einstein law of photochemical reactions? So according to this, each molecule of absorbing substance absorbs one photon. One photon or quantum of the radiation in primary process. So each molecule of absorbing substance absorbs one photon or quantum of the radiation in primary process. So a molecule acquire energy by absorbing photon as A as a molecule plus absorbing photon H nu energy. So undergoing excited state of molecule A star. Thus energy of photon is E is equal to H nu, where nu is a frequency of absorbing photon, H Planck constant. So the Planck constant value is 6.624 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule into second. So here a molecule acquire energy by absorbing photon as A plus H nu. So A as a molecule. So H nu absorbing energy as a photon. So the molecule undergoes excited state, that is denoted by A star. Thus energy of photon is E is equal to H nu, whereas nu is a frequency of absorbing photon, H is Planck constant, 6.624 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule into second. The energy of one mole photon, that is Einstein, is given by E is equal to nh nu. So n is Avogadro's number. This is equal to 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23. So, but nu is equal to C by lambda. We can write the Einstein equation, Einstein energy. E is equal to nhc by lambda. The velocity of a light, 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second or 10 to the power of 10 centimeter per second. So therefore, we can substitute the n value, h value, c value in Einstein equation. So we can get the E is equal to 1.1962 into 10 to the power of 8 by lambda joule per mole or kilojoule per mole. For this value in kilojoule per mole is 1196 0 by lambda. Lambda should be in centimeter. Laws of governing absorption of radiation. When a beam of light falls on a solution or homogeneous media, a portion of light is absorbed within the medium while the remaining is transmitted through the medium. Thus, if I0 is the intensity of radiation falling on the media, Ia is the amount of radiation absorbed, and It as the amount of radiation transmitted, then the equation we can written as I0 is equal to Ia plus It. I0 is intensity of radiation falling on the media. Ia is the amount of radiation absorbed. It as the amount of radiation transmitted. So this is the transmitted radiation, this is the absorbed radiation, this is the initial radiation, intensity of initial radiation falling on the media. So this is the incident light radiation. This is the IA transmitted, intensity of absorbed light. Next, this is the intensity of transmitted light. Where here C is the molar concentration of sample, B is the length of or thickness of the sample or cell. Lambert's law. When a monochromatic light passes through an absorbing medium at right angles to the plane of surface of medium or solution, the rate of decrease in intensity with the thickness of medium, that is denoted by B, is proportional to the intensity of incident light. In other words, the intensity of transmitted light decreases exponentially as the thickness of a medium increases automatically. So minus Ti by dB is equal to Kl, where I is equal to intensity of incident light of lambda wavelength, B is the thickness of medium, K is the proportionality constant. Now integrating the equation and putting I is equal to I0 when B is equal to 0. So this is the integration ln I0 by IT is equal to KB, or IT is equal to I0 into e to the power of minus KB, where I0 is equal to intensity of incident light falling on thickness B. So IT is equal to intensity of transmitted light, K absorption coefficient for the given wavelength and medium. Converting from natural logarithms to base 10 logarithms, that is IT is equal to I0 into 10 to the power of minus KB. Bayes law. Bernard and Beer independently stated that the intensity of incident light decreases exponentially as the concentration of absorbing medium increases automatically. This is similar to Lambert's law, and thus IT is equal to I0 into e to the power of minus K dash C. K dash is equal to proportionality constant. C is the concentration. By converting from natural logarithms to base 10, the equation can be written as IT is equal to I0 into 10 to the power of minus k dash c. Now, combining two laws, that is equations 3 and 5, we have IT is equal to I0 into 10 to the power of minus epsilon cb. So, k and k dash is equal to epsilon c concentration, b thickness of medium. Log I0 by IT is equal to epsilon CV, whereas epsilon is the molar extension coefficient, a constant dependent upon the wavelength of incident radiation and the nature of absorbing material, and the concentration is expressed in gram mole per liter. Since absorbance A is equal to log I0 by IT, you can infer that A is equal to epsilon BC. Equation of B, Lambert's law. This is the A is equal to epsilon BC is the equation for Baer-Lambert's law, where A absorbance or optical density, epsilon molar extension coefficient, C concentration of the sample, moles per liter, B path length, normally 10 mm to or 1 centimeter. You can take the path length 10 mm or 1 centimeter. So capital A is equal to small a BC, A for absorptivity, if concentration is expressed in gram per liter. So see here, once again, for an introduction of photochemistry. So, photochemistry deals with photochemical reactions caused by the absorption of light radiations from visible and ultraviolet region. So, electromagnetic spectrum having gamma rays to radio waves. So, in photochemical reaction, the radiation is useful for ultraviolet rays and visible rays. You can know the what are the thermal reactions, what are the photochemical reactions, what are the difference between thermal and photochemical reactions. So thermal reactions, these are ordinary chemical reactions which are influenced by temperature, concentration, pressure, catalyst, except the radiation, etc. These reactions involve evaluation of heat. The reaction is called exothermic reaction, or absorption of heat. The reaction is called endothermic reaction. So thermal reactions also divided into two types, exothermic reactions and endothermic reactions. Whereas in the case of photochemical reaction, the reactions which is induced by the absorption of electromagnetic radiation. In electromagnetic radiation, UV and visible region of radiation is utilized, is called as the photochemical reactions. See here, examples for exothermic thermal reactions and photochemical reactions. In thermal reactions, exothermic reactions and endothermic reactions, photochemical reactions, so here observe, these reactions occur in the presence of sunlight. Without sunlight, no reactions. So that's why you can take the concentration of hydrogen and Cl2 very high, absence of light, not get the 2HCl. In the presence of sunlight only, you can get the HCl from H2 and Cl2 molecules. Same similar, carbon dioxide water molecules in the presence of sunlight having chlorophyll, giving rise to carbohydrates and oxygen. This is the photochemical reaction. So the reaction is called photosynthesis. So plants having chlorophyll in the leaves, so using water and carbon dioxide, these plants prepared carbohydrates. So and eliminate the oxygen. This is called as a natural photosynthesis reaction. Also see here, carbon cycle. It is also a photochemical reaction. So formation of ozone in atmosphere also example for photochemical reaction. So using sunlight, O2 decomposes two single oxygens. This single oxygen reacts with O2 molecule to prepare ozone. So that's why formation of ozone also chemical, photochemical reaction. The difference between thermochemical reactions and photochemical reactions. Thermochemical reactions involve absorption or evaluation of heat, whereas photochemical reactions absorption only light. So thermochemical reactions also called as the dark reactions because absence of light in this reaction, that's why also called as the dark reactions. In photochemical reaction, the presence of light is a primary requisite. So in thermochemical reactions, rate of reaction depending on temperature, whereas in photochemical reaction, very little effect of temperature on rate of reaction. The Gibbs free energy delta Z value negative in thermochemical reaction. So Gibbs free energy delta Z value positive, not be negative in photochemical reaction. Thermochemical reactions accelerated by the presence of a catalyst. Photochemical reactions accelerated by the presence of photosensitizer. In photochemistry, Grotthus-Stauffer law, Einstein-Stauffer law are important. Only light that is absorbed can produce photochemical change according to Grotthus-Stauffer law. According to Einstein-Stauffer law, a molecule absorbs a single quantum of light is becoming excited. Grotthus-Stauffer law, only those radiations which are absorbed by a reacting substances or a system are responsible for producing chemical change. According to this law, all light radiations are not bringing the chemical reaction. Some are increases the kinetic energy of molecule, while some are re-emitted. That means the molecule undergoing physical changes. That is called as the fluorescence and phosphorescence. It is explained by the Jablonski diagram later on. So the dual nature of light, it means light behaves as a wave nature and behaves as a particle nature. This is called as the dual nature of the light. Whenever the dual nature of light behaves the wave nature, The wave properties are wavelength, frequency. So Einstein's torque law or Stark-Einstein law. From this, each molecule of absorbing substance absorbs one photon or quantum of the radiation in primary process. So a molecule acquire energy by absorbing photon as A plus H nu, giving rise to A star. This is the A per atom or molecule absorbing photon energy. It is undergoing excited state, A star. So A star means excited of atom or molecule. Here you can take the molecule, that's why excited molecule. You can say excited molecule. The energy of photon is E is equal to H nu, where nu is the frequency of absorbing photon, H Planck constant. The value is 6.624 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joule into second. The energy of one mole photon is given by Einstein equation, E is equal to nh nu, where nu is equal to c by lambda. So therefore, E is equal to nh c by lambda. N for Avogadro number, h for Planck constant, c for velocity of light, lambda is wavelength. Avogadro's number is 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23 molecules. C is the velocity of light, 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second, or 3 into 10 to the power of 10 centimeter per second. So you can substitute it in Einstein equation. You can get the E is equal to 0.6.023 into 10 to the power of 23 into 6.624 into 10 to the power of minus 34 into 3 into 10 to the power of 8 in by lambda into so, whereas this is not from minus 9. So E is equal to the value is joule per mole. This value is kilojoule per mole. Laws of governing absorption of radiation. When a beam of light falls on a solution or homogeneous media, a portion of light is absorbed within the medium, while the remaining is transmitted through the medium. Thus, if I0 is the intensity of radiation falling on the media, Ia is the amount of radiation absorbed, and It is the amount of radiation transmitted. The equation is written as I0 is equal to Ia plus It. So, see here, incident light I, or I0. So this is the IA. This is the absorbed light. This is the transmitted light. C is the molar concentration of sample. B is the length or thickness of the sample. So Lambert's law. When a monochromatic light passes through an absorbing media at right angles to the plane of surface of medium or solution, the rate of decrease in intensity with thickness of medium, that is the thickness of medium denoted by B, small b, is proportional to the intensity of incident light. In other words, the intensity of transmitted light decreases exponentially as the thickness of medium increases automatically. You can write the minus di by dv is equal to ki, where I is equal to intensity of incident light of lambda wavelength, b is thickness of medium, k is proportionality constant. Now integrated the above equation, ln I0 by it is equal to kb, or it is equal to I0 into e to the power of minus kb. So I0 is equal to intensity of incident light falling on thickness B. IT is equal to intensity of transmitted light. K is equal to absorption coefficient for the given wavelength and medium. Converting the natural logarithm of above equation, we can write the IT is equal to I0 into 10 to the power of minus KB. This is the third equation. So now combining two laws, that is the equation 3 and 5, we have IT is equal to I0 into 10 to the power of minus epsilon CB. Here C concentration, B thickness. Thus, log I0 by IT is equal to E epsilon CB. Here epsilon is the molar extension coefficient. It is depending upon the wavelength, absorbing material, and the concentration. This is expressed in concentration taken in gram mole per liter, gram into mole per liter. So since absorbance A is equal to log I0 by IT, we can write the equation above the equation. A is equal to epsilon BC. This is the Beer-Lambert's law. A, absorbance or optical density, epsilon molar extension coefficient, the concentration of the sample, mole per liter, B, path length. Normally you can take the 10 mm or 1 centimeter, or the reaction is written also A is equal to small a BC. Small a is equal to absorptivity. So this is the Beer-Lambert's law. So thank you. We are continue for next class.